There are seats in the front here, guys. So, sit down, please. Okay, welcome again for the first time in this lecture hall, and welcome to a journey into year 2099. You will indeed be shaping future. We'll be talking together and working on something where politics indeed has not done a very good job over the last decade or so. We have not a good strategy as Europe on how to deal with something that is really the most beautiful opportunity a society can get. All of us will be much older than our parents and grandparents, and our children, your children, when they will be born, are likely to be above 100 years old when they die. Normal situation, not exception. And this is a wonderful situation for a society to be in, and it is a situation where our society is really not equipped to answer. So, we are looking to you, to all of you, to come up with ideas, ideas that we call demographic solutions. Ideas not for others to do, not for somebody else out there, some politician should do this or that, but something you can do and you can leave a mark. That's what we will be working on during this week. Before we get started, I have two logistical things I would need to ask you. First, you noticed we are split up in cohorts, and that means we are sharing lecturers. Behind that is a relatively complicated logistics, and it requires us to be totally on time. We are now starting 10 minutes late, which is bad, because it means that we have to cut the introductory lecture now by 10 minutes and some things you will not be able to get. So I will please ask you, be on time for these plenary sessions for the benefit of you, that you get all the information you want, for the benefit of your teams, that you can get all the feedback, and also for the benefits of your fellow students who are tutors, mentors, and in the organizing team trying to make this work. The second thing is just a warning. This lecture hall, that's exactly what I wanted to say, this lecture hall has one particularity. When you speak, I can hear every word in the front. I can even understand what you say, so please be aware, this is an odd acoustics here. Please don't speak. If you have to speak during the lecture, please go out, do your conversation, and come back in. Bert. Yeah? It's very difficult to concentrate. So, but now we have to start, and we want to get started with what we are trying to achieve. Let me run you through this week. We are now in module 2. In module 2, you will be introduced to 3 megatrends. What is a megatrend? It's something really big that is going on, that has a certain dynamic, and we want to understand it. In this case, we are talking about what really makes up demographic change, how can you describe it, what is the language we want to use to talk about it? What are the main factors? And these 3 megatrends will be introduced to you later in 3 presentations. The next module, tomorrow morning, deals with what at all can we do if we are all getting older, if anything seems to happen anyway, why are we talking about it? How can society, how can we intervene with it? So we are talking then about the intervention systems. What can we do? Who can intervene? How can you intervene? How can all of us contribute to that? Module 4 then shows you different solutions or different opportunities that others have already taken. So you are not the first to think about that. There are people that already built ideas on how to take into the opportunity of an aging society. And some of these people will introduce to you their solutions. This is module 4. Then we flip the page and we get to you. Module 5 is a module where we will ask you for the first time, what do you want to do? How does the question and your personal interest go together? What would you be passionate about starting? The Wednesday, module 6, 7, and 8 is all about refining your ideas. It is about first to convince yourself by doing more analysis that your idea is actually a good one. And it may not be. This is why in module 5, each team will start with many ideas. And over the course of Wednesday, in the evening, you probably have only 1 or 2 ideas left. So in module 6, you do a lot more detail. You convince yourself by analysis. In module 7, in your team, you will discuss your solutions. So you will controversially challenge each other's ideas. So you are starting to convince others inside your team. And in module 8, in the evening of Wednesday, your task is to start building a presentation that would finally convince the European Parliament, any government, or any investor to actually do what you are trying to change. So module 8 will be around building a first presentation that can speak with you, but that can also speak for itself. On Thursday, nearly 50 experts will come here. People who have worked in this field and many times for decades, academics, CEOs, investors, politicians, parliamentarians, who are experts in the particularities of what you are trying to achieve, and you have the opportunity to ask them for input. You may choose to not ask them, but that would be silly. You may choose to make sure that they understand what you are trying to say, and that they can help you say it even better, or to find mistakes. Module 10 then deals with people who know how to professionally hold presentations. Because in the end, being right and others recognizing that you are right is two very different things. We have seen this often in history. So in module 10, presentation experts will help you to brush up your presentation so that not only you, but especially others who haven't heard your content before will understand it. And in the evening, in module 11, the early evening, you will be, all of you, each team will be at least doing one presentation in front of the jury. This make sure that every team gets to a final presentation and that the jury has the opportunity to really look at every team's end product. The jury will then sit together on Thursday evening while you sleep and will determine who will be invited to present again in front of the big group that will then be all of us, including the group from Vamos together, on the big stage on Friday morning. We will not be able to tell you, so you will find out when you come on Friday morning whether you have to present or not. And then the jury will select two winners. And as I explained already in the church, one of the winning teams will go to the European Parliament and explain in one of the big halls the finding of the team to parliamentarians. I think, Larissa, is somebody of your team here? No, because there was a winning team who went the last time 2 years ago to Brussels, but I think they are in the other cohort as tutors, okay? And the second winner will actually go to Jordan, to Amman, and work with one of the king's not-for-profit who is supporting refugees, older refugees, who got misplaced due to the ISIS and the Syrian war. So that's an opportunity to volunteer in a country that's associated to the European Union, and the King's Fund is taking care of flights and your accommodation and everything else. So this is two prizes, and you will find that out only at the end of our Friday session. What do we want you to learn here? Most importantly, we want you to understand that you can indeed make a difference. So what you do at university will empower you to structure your thoughts in a way that they can influence society, science, whatever path you go. This is why it's so important for us that you all come to an end product. Secondly, we like you to work in teams. We would like very much all of us to understand that alone there is very little you will be able to do. You may be the brightest person in the world. Behind each major improvement is always a team. And working in a team to get the best out of everybody in such a social working environment is critical for us at Leuphana, and this is why we would like to encourage you to use that already in your first week. The third thing we like you to do is to be transparent and to use methods. So whatever you do will be reviewable by your peers. So you upload your assignment to the platform, and everybody else in the class of 2017 can look at it and can comment. And we invite you to make use of that function. This is not about stealing, this is about contributing, and it shows one more time that having the idea is much less important than actually working it out all the way to the end. So this is what we like you to get out of it. On a different sheet of paper, the most important thing is that you get to know your peers. Most of you will be together for this study program, but some of them probably also for life. And I don't mean only romantic relationships, I actually mean that this will be a professional as well as a private network for all of you. Get to know your colleagues, and also get to know your colleagues that are studying different majors or minors than you do. This is one of the reasons why here we are scattered around the way how this has been organized. So that's the entire trick. You know, you have tutors, that will support you in the process, and every two teams have a mentor. Neither tutors nor mentors are school teachers. They have a different role. A mentor is here to help you learn. They help you manage your own learning process, to manage your group process, to manage the way how you deal with content. A tutor is here regarding general questions of the university and organizational questions. They play a different role. And then there's a big teaching staff who will help you with your assignments and will help you with all of the content that you need to resolve them. All lectures will be on class of 2017 as quickly as they are available. All documents anybody has shown will be on class of 2017 quickly available. And all assignments, as you already know, can only be submitted that way. And you will receive your feedback also electronically in class of 2017. Each session has a similar structure. We are always meeting here in plenary, and you will get content. The first content session for you will start in 8 minutes, and you will hear about 3 megatrends. Then you go in your team, and you resolve your assignment, you upload the assignment, and you come back here into the plenary. In the plenary, always 2 or 3 teams will present to the rest, and we will discuss. So this is a joint debrief. And one of the benefits of an electronic platform is that we can also look at everything you have done and help you better that way. All of this is set and laid out in a process where the university here in Lüneburg is applying to the European Union for a very, very large research and development grant. This is why so many faculty members from other universities are here participating in your freshman week. It is a very massive grant we are trying to get. It's something that in that dimension has never really come to Germany beforehand. Our partners in that are Harvard University, MIT Media Lab, Zurich University, Weizmann Institute in Israel, Hebrew University, Technion, and two large member states as such, Malta and Croatia, and then as non-member states, Israel and Jordan. So it's a relatively heavy effort that is also tailored and tries to answer the question around demographic opportunities for Europe. So in a way, what you are doing here is you are giving input into a big upcoming European research project. It's a rarely given opportunity, and this is one of the things that also makes up Leuphana. We try in all relevant research projects we have to get and create as much opportunities for students as possible, because it's your world, and you are much more likely to enjoy academia and enjoy the opportunities if you can also give and not only take. So nearly caught up in time. So, the module that comes up now is called Megatrends in Demographic Change. We will be, you got it, we are now in the content. Process is over. So we are looking at 3 big deals that are usually meant if people use that technical term demographic change. So what does it mean? demographic change means two things. One is everybody gets older. In Europe, much older than we used to be. Secondly, we don't have as many children anymore. And as you rightfully guess, this is a process that goes in the same direction in terms of what it means for society. What does it mean for society? At 4 o'clock here, you have a word, continuously worsening dependency ratio. That sounds very complicated, but it's very simple. Right now, there is people who are in work, who are going to earn, who are earning a living for their families, and X many people at work have to pay and care for people who are not working because they are older or they are younger. Now, if we have more and more people that get much older and less younger people entering that system, obviously over time, a person in work will have to pay for more and more people that are not working. And at our social standards that we have rightfully been fighting for since the French Revolution, this is a big issue. It would mean that you have to pay for out of your salary, one way or the other, whether it goes out by tax or by social insurances, or you pay for it directly, for substantially more people than we currently do. The second thing is, all these years we are gaining are not necessarily healthy years. So if a person will now be 104 years old, that person has an expectancy of maybe 17 years with chronic diseases. Again, this is good news, because right now we are still dying from lots of cancers, and they are highly likely to be chronic very soon. But then you are ill. You don't die anymore, but you are ill. So it's a different society. Most importantly, maybe from your current perspective, though, is what's written at 7 o'clock here. If somebody will be 104 years old, like this girl that's born in the Lüneburg Hospital today, she will want to participate in society for 104 years. We are a democracy. We are an active society. We want everybody to be involved and to have that opportunity. That means we really need to learn lifelong. It's not anymore going to school, going to university, learning for a job, retiring at 64, and then what, the remaining 40 years? So lifelong learning becomes a totally different meaning, and it starts at birth as a concept for society, allowing us to participate in society in a more meaningful way. So these three mega trends that make up demographic change will now be introduced to you by three distinguished speakers. With us is Jürgen Wettke, who will talk about the facts around chronic diseases. Jürgen has been in pharmaceuticals and in industry consulting for many years and is now a professor in Düsseldorf. Dr. Wallwey is co-leading the IAB, one of Germany's most prestigious workplace-related research institutions, the scientific center of the Bundesagentur für Arbeit. And he will introduce to you, as the second speaker here, the logic around workplace and demographic change. last speaker here will be Philip Schmidt. Philip is leading the lifelong kindergarten at MIT Media Lab. So this is MIT's lifelong learning research institution. And Philip will introduce you to this topic. What you then will have to do is actually quite simple, but sometimes the simplest things are the most complicated. We will ask you to summarize what you have heard from these three speakers. So, listening comprehension. Now, we would like to hear from you what you have heard from the speakers in simple words. And we would like you to answer where in this is potentially the opportunity. For this, you will have at 15:15 in the platform this template. It's a text enter template where you can please, at the deadline, then submit your solution before we meet again here in the plenary. Now, very quickly, with the photo upload, we prolonged the upload deadline until 3:10 now. Some teams here didn't get their upload done, so you can do that now, please, as we proceed here in parallel. So the platform is open until 3:10 for that, and then at 3:15, this assignment will be open. That's our plan. Any questions on process? No. So the stage now belongs to Jürgen.